Hi guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm actually gonna be showing you how to make this pet playground right behind me. The other day, I saw a comment on one of my videos saying that a whole bunch of people are trying to recreate this pet playground, but they're not really sure how. So in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you how I did this. So it's kind of like a little mini tutorial. If you guys like to figure out how to make this pet playground, then definitely hit that subscribe button and let's go ahead and get into the video. So this is what the pet playground currently looks like right now. This is the penthouse apartment. If you guys are wondering what type of house this house has a very high ceiling. So that is how I was able to kind of just achieve this look right here. Of course, you can try to make it shorter, but I recommend having a high ceiling house or like a two-story that has like this very open like area so that you guys can do this, because this thing is quite tall. So if we go all the way up here, it's like a little mini ramp for our pets to go on top of. And then there's also food bowls, and then we have our little DIY pet house right there along with some toys. And this is kind of just like a sky backdrop, as you guys can see, with like cylinders on each side. All right, so we are up here where our little DIY hack station is. I already have the ground and the backdrop set up. These are just four large walls. They look like this white one back here, as well as like the large wall like platforms on the bottom. This is kind of going to be like a talk through type of tutorial. So first we want to lay out our square. I'm going to be showing you guys how to exactly make the one that I have in my living room. Of course you guys can create your own. If like you have like a smaller house or something, you can try to create your own. Let me know down below in the comments if you want to see a video of like recreating a pet playground for like one story houses or like smaller homes. I can do that for you guys. So the first things first, we want to place our square onto the far left side, and then we also want to place this little triangle ramp right here. Okay, so if you guys are wondering what these shapes are, oh my gosh, it's not close. Okay, so we're gonna go to shapes and squares. I use the large square right here for that square, and then the wedges for the ramp, I use a large wedge. So that is what this kind of looks like together. It's supposed to look like a little on-ramp so that our pets can easily get into or go on top of. So here's the tricky part, is getting our ramp. So these are the small walls. You can find these in the slab section. This is going to be the small wall right here. We're going to need three of these. Actually, we may end up needing four. These are the ones that are going to go in the pet playground. I'm going to duplicate one more so we can just use that wall as like a guide. So let's change the color of this to like blue or something. Let's do something like that to kind of just remind us that that is not part of it. So this is the hard part, guys. Okay, so this is the hard part, is actually figuring out how to do this and get the wall to face down. Okay guys, so this is the tricky part, is figuring out how to get our wall to face downwards, like diagonal. And the best way that I found out how to do that is to get the practice wall or like the guide wall to like be slanted like that, and then we're gonna go ahead and lean this wall on the side like this. Of course, this is gonna take some adjustments. Building in Overlook Bay has this weird glitch to where if you move a shape, it loses its position, which I'm not really much of a fan on, but we're going to have to place it downwards like this. So if we can get it straight enough, of course this weird annoying glitch happens too as well, but what are we gonna do about it? Okay, we're just gonna have to go with it. All right guys, so that actually kind of took me a while to figure out. This is the best that I can do. It's okay if it looks like that, but that's basically the gist of how to actually get that wall to go down like that. So the next thing you want to do is also another tricky part. We're gonna want to make sure our wall is straight this time like this. We actually might end up having to add another section right here to kind of just fill up that space. And we're gonna go ahead and figure out if we can, okay, so we want this to be like this obviously, so we're going to have to move this wall a little bit closer to, let's try there, and kind of just guess. We want this tip right here to match up with this tip right here, so let's go ahead and do that. All right, guys, so I ended up adding another wall section right here so that we can have space to build. All right, guys, so the next few shapes that we're gonna use to recreate the little platform, the first floor right here, I guess we can call it, is these are the small squares. I used kind of a lot of these actually to kind of just line up right here so that we can make a little platform. So I'm going to go ahead and place these squares like this, and I want to make sure that I have enough space to add another wall right here, which you guys will see pretty soon. All right, guys, so now that we have our little platform ready right there, this is where it gets even more tricky, and we're going to need another wall going upwards like this. So what we are going to go ahead and do is we are going to kind of get our guide wall back again, and we're going to have to do the same thing that we did right here to kind of just get that wall slanted. And this is going to take a few tries. I'm not going to lie, if you guys are doing this on mobile, then you guys are troopers. I cannot do this on mobile. Anyways, guys, so this is what we're basically going to do like that. That is exactly what we're going to do to kind of just get our wall slanted like this. So it's not perfect, but I think it's pretty good for the first try, actually. You guys, look at that. Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and leave it like that. And the next thing that we want to do is we're going to go ahead and remove this practice wall, and we're going to go ahead and duplicate more of these small squares, and we're going to create another platform like this, but we're going to go ahead and make it a little bit wider, maybe add another row of squares so that we can fit a pet house or like even like food bowls and toys at the top. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and place those squares at the top. So this is gonna also be kind of tricky too. We're going to have to use a good eye and kind of just try and line these up just like so, I guess, like that. Okay, so I think that's fine right there. So let's go ahead and duplicate more of these. All right, guys, so there we go. We have our top platform at the top. I'm gonna go ahead and get that guide wall back again because we are going to use it to build a pet house. And I did actually already lay out like the little platforms right here, the little walls that we can use to make the pet house. You guys have already seen me do this, but if you guys don't know how to do this, I'll show you guys real quickly. So you're going to use a guide wall like this and make sure that our walls line up evenly like this. And then we're going to go ahead and do the same on this side right here. Let me go ahead and get that last piece right here and kind of just line that up with this shape. All right, guys, so after that, we're gonna go ahead and place the wall inside the shapes like this, and we're gonna go ahead and get our roof like this. It should look something like this, and ta-da, we have a pet house at the top. And then of course you can add like a pet bed and then toys and stuff like that. That is exactly how you make the platform of the pet playground. Now here's another tricky part. Get our practice wall again, and we're gonna go ahead and add the little swinging doggy bed that I have, and then we're gonna use the boxy pet bed right here. This is exactly what it looks like. Let me go ahead and recolor it to, I guess, white for now so that we can see it, and we're gonna go ahead and place it on top of this wall. We want to make sure that it's directly under the second platform right here. Okay, so here's another confusing thing. So whenever I play around with shapes like this, it does that weird turning thing, and I don't know how to actually stop that from happening. So let's go ahead and grab these neon light bars. So these are neon light bars, and I like to use these as, okay, so let's see. Oh my gosh, no, it's too high. All right, guys, so the thing with these is that if you add these a little too high like this, it might actually go through the top platform, as you guys can see. So we're just gonna have to figure out how high or low we want this bed to be. Again, this is kind of just like a trial and error thing. All right, guys, so we have the neon light bars on the swing like that, and kind of just line it up with the rest of the neon light bars instead of guessing. So this is pretty much how you do the swing. This is exactly like the swing, guys. So I really want there to be like an undo button when it comes to building. So let's say you like accidentally move a shape that you totally did not mean to. How cool would it be to have like an undo button? All right, so we're just gonna leave it like that, and we're gonna go ahead and place our shapes up here. So these are the shapes that you can find. I believe it's like Myst. Yeah, you can find these shapes in Myst, and it's the circular triangle. And you guys have seen this in my build hacks where I like to use this to make a giant circle, kind of like this. So this is going to act as a sun. And of course, guys, you can customize this to however you want. It doesn't have to be like a sun like mine. And in my house, I have like little clouds around it, kind of covering it. So we're gonna go ahead and add these like this and kind of just around the sun. You don't have to do this part. This part is like completely optional. I really like this happy sunny day backdrop that I have going on in my house. Like I have clouds going down here as well. And this area too is where like I have the clouds and stuff. And then of course, guys, you can add like pet toys or pet beds, like another pet bed on this second floor or the first floor. That is pretty much it on how you guys can make this pet playground. In my house, I have cylinders kind of just hiding the edges of this part so it's not like sticking out pretty weird. And then I do have a bunch of spheres towards the bottom to act as bushes. But that is pretty much it, how you make the pet playground or like pet wall playground, I guess you can say. So we can go up here and we can go ahead and put our pets in there like that. And yeah, guys, that is pretty much it. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you want to see a tutorial for anything that is in my apartment and I will do it for you guys. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to give this video a thumbs up as well as hit that subscribe button and make sure to turn that subscribe button from red to silver so that you guys can be notified whenever I upload a new video as well as I go live. So yeah, I really want you guys to be a part of those. I always have so much fun in my live streams with you guys and sometimes I'll have my joins on for you guys to join me in those live streams. So make sure you are subscribed and make sure you also have your notifications enabled. But anyways, guys, I hope you have an amazing day and I will see you guys next time. Bye!